Hello guys, my name is Plantas MC and well, this is a game where you punch a wall. I honestly have no idea why I'm doing this. I just like these kinds of games for some reason. I don't really know why, but they're fun to me. I know they're kind of stupid, as in really stupid, but the real reason I like these games so much is because, for videos, I mean, it's because you may have already figured out by now, I love to talk. I think that's quality YouTubers share. We love to talk. That's why we do YouTube, because we love to talk to people and we like playing games. And this is a game where I can just talk. So, this game is called Wall Destroyer, and it was made on Idle Game Maker. Now, to be honest, most games from that site are really not very good. And actually, let me rephrase my previous statement. I like Idle Games. I like what Idle Games can be, but there aren't very many that meet my standards. I have high standards for games. And yeah, to be honest, not many games meet my standards. I'm kind of little harsh at that, but so basically, you click this wall, and I've gotten an achievement for damaging it. And the nice thing about this game is that it actually has a goal, and it's extremely hard to get to. I've never gotten close to beating this game, but it does have a real goal. And so, let's just punch the wall. In my opinion, it's harder than Cookie Clicker because the price curve is a lot more difficult than that than Cookie Clicker is. So, got an achievement, gloves. They'll increase it by 50%, and hand punches do a little more damage too. And so, this game also has a lot more potential than Cookie Clicker because you can keep unlocking stuff long after you've stopped in Cookie Clicker, which is good because you will be unlocking stuff right up until you beat this game. And this game takes a very long time to beat. It's almost infinite, but it's not. I don't know why my screen is glitching out so much right now. Probably because I'm uploading another video while I'm doing this. So it's always like this with like the early stages of these games. You still have to actually do work. But even already, I don't really have to do that much. I can just sit around and talk. Now, again, the reason I have been doing Minecraft is because I don't like how laggy the computer is. And again, I'm getting a new computer on Christmas. It's only 11 days away as I record this. I'm a scrub now. I'm a scrub. And yes, I know most of you guys are people I already know, and you already know this, but again, I like talking, and again, just in case someone new comes along and watches this. Because I've always been looking out for new people viewing after my first upload, the glasses mod. Because that has gotten over 50 views. It's gotten about almost 10 times my average views. I've gotten 100 views so far. May have already said that, but again, I haven't uploaded half my Epic Battle Fantasy videos. I will be uploading more of those in the future. And so I'm not gonna be like trying to do everything I can to progress through this game, because this is mostly the time when I get to talk without doing anything. So most of the things I'm probably going to be doing on this channel are Minecraft and stuff like Epic Battle Fantasy and this. And so, but some of the stuff is also, I also like creepypasta, but I probably won't be uploading too many creepypasta videos, but you will hear it mentioned a good amount in my videos. And so, if you're the kind of person that isn't really too scared, isn't really scared that easily, just go check him out. You may find out that you aren't as easily scared as I thought. That's what happened to me. I'd be like scared to death by some of the stuffins. Turns out I can shrug a lot of it off, to be honest. Creepypasta, I like it. It's just. Yeah. And don't get me wrong, I don't like the graphic stuff. I think too much of that just detracts from it, but. Stuff that's deep and just sort of a little unsettling. That's stuff I like. And now. Minecraft. Love Minecraft. And a friend of mine introduced the game to me. And to be honest, up until about a year and a. About. Wow, almost 2 years ago. Up until about that time, I was a hater. I just like hated on every Minecraft thing I could find. And. It's also a little funny because I love the game because I've been obsessed with the game. My obsessions come and go, but Minecraft has stuck around persistently for 1.5 years now. First played in June. The first YouTuber I ever watched was the Diamond Minecart. And I really like him. The problem is that I feel like he's turned a bit too much of his attention toward younger audiences. Because if you saw Treyarch gets kidnapped, all of his fans are 9-year-olds. And it's not just that. I just feel like I've been distant. I'm just. It's not just that. I just feel like I've been becoming more distant from him. He doesn't do as many mod reviews as I would like. He's branched off a lot from Minecraft since I started watching him. And also, he really likes mini games and stuff, but. Also, most of what he does these days is series, and. For some reason, just never caught on. The idea of. I mean, individual videos are okay, but the thing about individual videos is that you can pick up at any point and start watching. You may not get every reference, but even in things like popular MMOs as challenge games, you might not get things like the David Copperfield reference, but for the most part, you can pick it up and play it pretty easily. And so. Yeah, pick it up and play it easily. And I'm just gonna get 100 hand damage, see if anything happens. Okay, got an achievement, Puncher. I'm a puncher now, guys. I can punch things. Now I'm just gonna get some stuff for a bit. Become very good at clicking. According to a cookie clicker site that has an ability to measure clicking, cookie.remu.net, I can click it around 6 times a second at maximum speed if I am. Clicking my computer touchpad. I'm a little slower on the mouse. Strangely, clicking both at the same time does not do anything for me to help. Maybe it's just because of my brain, I can only focus on so many clicks at once. It's a bit weird. But so, I could be getting through this definitely a lot faster if I clicked a ton. That's just what I'm gonna do. And so, I'm sorry the screen is glitching up. Guess because I'm uploading another video. Uploading the Five Nights at Freddy's mod, and mod maker, please bring the old mod back. Because, to be honest, I'm just going to say it. I hate what they've done to it. I absolutely hate what they have done to that mod. The mod sucks now. And again, some things need to happen, like the nerfing of Foxy's hook. Other things didn't need to happen. Because. That's the thing, you're not supposed to be able to. Even in Minecraft, where you can fight all the creepypasta and stuff with the right mod, it's not supposed to be easy to take down the animatronics. I think that they should have, like, the health they used to have in, like, before these mods were combined. Golden Freddy should be kept at 400 and of his previous damage. Because that was still strong, but not as overpowered as 8,000 health. But anyway, I'm getting sidetracked. Just with the Diamond Minecart, half the time is doing series, which I don't know. I don't like having to watch, like, for Sims 3, he's got like 10 hours of footage at this point. And sure, I watched some of it, but I am just, first of all, I'm a little repulsed because every YouTuber I've seen has obviously no very little empathy for Sims. I mean, Dan can at least pass it off as pass himself off as caring a little, but he'll just ditch marriages and remarry at a whim. Even once his friends have already have kids. I'm less of a scrub now, guys. But he'll do that, and maybe I'm weird. I'm being weird for this. I am, but that just, I just don't like that sort of thing when it happens for some reason. It just turns me off. At least he's not Sundy, who is absolutely psychotic in his series. I am. It's gotten bad enough in his that I'm actually worried if he is, like, entirely sane. I am actually a little worried because maybe he just is, like, almost. Maybe he just can't, like, empathize with characters very well. I've met some people who are like that. But also, the Diamond Minecart just does a lot of series and Diamond Dimension. He's got several days of footage on that. And don't really know most of the mods he's got, but I know. Combination of the stuff I said, I've just drifted away from him. Popular MMOs. I like him because if he's acting, it's very hard to tell most of the time when he is. He definitely doesn't. He doesn't seem to do it very often, which is good. He has Jen, and it's. And I like that because it's almost a YouTube duo, but not quite. That sort of balance just. I like that. I like that sort of balance in this stuff. It's almost, but not quite. So, and I love his challenge games. I think he needs to do something other than Five Nights at this point because he's done four in a row now. I mean, without that, the Daver Copperfield probably wouldn't have come up. But other than that, yeah. He has got to be my favorite YouTuber now. Just love his vids. And he's good at. And he's good enough at PvP not to completely flub it. He can fight the mobs. Maybe he needs to get out a little more on servers, but he just doesn't seem like the kind of guy who plays on servers, you know? Just, he's a guy who likes being alone on YouTube. And except with Jen. And he gives just enough information to seem to get to know him a little bit. Just, I know. Better clubs. Simply feels better to hold. That sounds weird. I'm just gonna say now, that sounds. That is weird. Like, how does a club feel better to hold? Now, something I recommend that anyone I haven't told yet goes on is site called the SCP Foundation. Now, the SCP Foundation can be a little scary, but it's not a creepypasta. Because other people consider them to be a creepypasta, but they do not consider themselves to be creepypasta anymore. They used to be, but they're not anymore. And they've actually produced some really interesting stuff. The SCP Foundation, what it is, it's just the. It's a fake government organization that catalogs anomalous phenomena. Basically, anything that the laws of physics just say should not happen, they put it in. A statue that if you blink, it will come up to you and kill you, Weeping Angel style. But was, interestingly enough, created before the Weeping Angels, anomalous object. A creature that will. A staircase that never ends with a creature that will stalk you when you go down it, anomalous object. A ball that will bounce forever, anomalous object. A monkey statue that goes to whoever can pull off the best prank, and tidies up their office and leaves little traps for them. And I'm not kidding, that is in there, anomalous object. The site goes from fu from sk to bone chilling, from bone chilling to absolutely hilarious, depending on what part of the site you're on. Some question the use of swords on a brick wall. Those guys are lame. So, SCP Foundation, I've been putting a lot of time into that. There's also the Minecraft Conception Wiki, where I can be found under the name Plantroboon. We've been added on the Minecraft Conception Wiki for a year, and what we do there is basically those who can't program create ideas for mods on there. I guess it's half posting just to post, and half and a little bit so that someone might notice and create a mod out of it. I personally have been trying to learn to actually code because I don't like having to depend on stuff like that. I want to actually go out there and do something. It's just, I'm just weird that way. So, thinking of maybe buying a few more punchers, but no, that wouldn't be that good of an investment. I'm almost ready to buy a sword anyway. And so, on the Minecraft Conception Wiki, I didn't create it, but it's mostly been me on the wiki. There are some other users, but we've had many problems with everyone just hiding in the forums and doing absolutely nothing. The users on there are myself, Plantroboon, I'm an administrator there, Wikicool, the creator, who like most wiki creators, left, Kamikaze Wolf, who actually tried to do stuff but got frustrated by everyone in the forums, Judbud, Creeper something, and Minecraft 999999, who just stay in the forums. They do absolutely nothing but stay in the forums. I'm sorry if any of you, if I ever post a link to my channel on my page and any of you three watch this, I am sorry, but that is all you guys do. Please leave the forums and start concepting. It's not Forum Game Wiki. That is not what we came here to do. At least not what I came here to do. And you'll see, I do a lot of things on there. Most of them are incomplete and probably will be incomplete for a while. Currently, I'm doing, well, you'll see if you go there. But it's related to some stuff I've been talking about in this video and shows that I might be a bit too obsessive and oh crap, I got 666 cash. I mean, I heard that a lot of people don't like the number 666, and I know this like the whole number of the devil and all that, but it's just a number, guys. It's just a number. And just a second, my video finished uploading. Sorry. That does confirm that I can keep my volume off and you will still hear me, which is very useful. My damage, guys, is over 9,000! Sorry, I just like doing that. Well, yeah. And guys, for people who I actually know, we're basically all of you guys right now, you've probably heard all this before. Sorry if this is a little boring. But just, it's good. And so, I might actually talk about this game a little bit. Now, you can buy all the stuff you see here. Now, first thing about this game is that it has m is that I am fairly certain that it has better is like better return on your investment basically for stuff than Cookie Clicker. But it might have worse, I don't know. Like this is 30 base damage. It really depends because for Cookie Clicker they released this new update that completely overhauls the entire game. I haven't played it yet. But basically if you knew the game before, you don't know it anymore, guys. It has changed completely. And so, promise to do a few more mod reviews. I've always wanted to do Orspawn, but it's just such a huge mod that I think Orspawn is one where I kind of have to have already been reviewing it for a while. Can't just jump on the bandwagon at this point, because it would take 2 hours to review everything, and I'm a purist, I like to review everything. And besides, by the time it uploads, there will probably be a new update. Although they haven't come out with one in a while. Now, I feel like. So, the reason I've been able to record so long is that the whole family's out right now, out of the house. I've been alone for a couple hours. And that's been pretty nice. I've just been able to talk without any, like, obligations and stuff. Club step. So, there's also this other game I like called Dance Dance Revolution. And yes, it's a dancing game. And I know that dancing games have always been like supposed to be dancing games for girls, but no, this is not. Mainly because the true masters, I've never seen any. To be honest, first of all, the fact that I have never seen any female DDR YouTubers, they're all guys. But also because basically a game where you lay out a map with arrow panels. There's four arrow panels like a keyboard. And when arrows come up, and arrows will come from the bottom on a screen, and when they reach the top, you have to tap them. But here's the thing. You have to do this with your foot in real life. That's probably obvious because it's a dancing game, but that means that this is also an exercise game. It's an easy and fun way to get your exercise because the songs they have some songs from existing off artists, but most of the best songs they make themselves. And the company creating this is Konami, so they obviously have the budget to do a ton of stuff. And basically, DDR is actually 16 years old now. They've been doing it a while and it's still going. In my opinion, the golden age of the game has ended. It ended a while ago, but still very good. I suggest you check it out. There's a program called Stepmania that lets you do it on the keyboard. And also, if you buy a USB adapter, which can be a little hard to find but not too hard, and a DDR mat, which are a little expensive but not too expensive. You can basically play the game in real life. You have to find all the songs and download them, but they're all on the site Bandicam. No, I mean they're all on the site Xenius iVanisher, so that should really take a few days at best. That should take a few days at most to get everything. And because Stepmania is not made by Konami, they cannot charge. Congratulations, you guys got several $100 worth of video games for free. I mean, it doesn't include like some of the mission modes and stuff, but no one really cares about those anyway. How do you like that, Konami? Ha! No one's gonna buy your games anymore. Now, Stepmania is not a laggy program. Just because this computer can run it lag-free most of the time. There are like occasional spikes, but those are like 15 minutes at best and last for like a second. And this is probably one of the oldest computers that, like, anyone I know is still actually using for stuff, so you should be able to run it on any computer that you have. I think it's compatible with Windows and Macs. Macs, not sure about Linux, but I've never owned a Linux. And I know that's like a, I think that's like a programming language, but kind of a noob at this stuff. And so, again, guys, this video is going to be quite a bit longer than regular videos. Probably. It's already like 24 minutes, 25 minutes now. And I'm planning to go on for a little bit longer. It's gonna be like a little, like, I don't know. I won't be doing these too often, but when like something major comes up over And I have enough subscribers that I can talk to all of them, but it's kind of annoying. Besides, I don't really know most of them anymore. And guys, I have to tell you a secret. First of, I do not subscribe to myself because I think that's kind of dicky, but three of my subscribers are actually dummy accounts created by one of my friends. Yep, so I really have only six subscribers. But it's just a one step at a time process, you know. In my opinion, if you're making videos for the subscribers, you are not going to be getting subscribers. If you're making them just for that, you have to put like energy into the videos. You have to really me you have to really like what you're doing. Because if you get frustrated without subscribers, you're not going to be on there long enough to get subscribers. I know, guys. I mean, I'm not sure what kind of special talent it takes to get like 10,000 of subscribers. To be honest, as Sky Does Minecraft proves, it's almost random. I'm sorry to any Sky fans, but first of all, Sky is PewDiePie now. Second of all, Sky is just, he's just not that funny. He really isn't. I mean, the squid was funny at first, but now it just gets in the way of his mod reviews. And most of the videos I actually like that were made by him are over a year old. So, I'm sorry, Sky fans. And also, everyone's saying that Sky stole butter from Sea Nanners, because if you don't know, Sea Nanners actually created butter by saying that he had butter shoes when he had gold shoes on. And my question is, why can't it be both? I mean, the 10 million Sky fans don't get hated on when they call gold butter, and they do it all the time. I mean, half the comments on Sky videos are butter, butter, butter. So, can't really hate them for that. And I think the five clubbers are gonna be as maybe a little more expensive than the swordsman, but I don't care. Gonna buy a few clubbers just so I can get more stuff. Because the next building is 16,000, as you've almost certainly seen by now. And thing is that destroying this wall actually cost a trillion damage, like the all-time damage, not money, so I don't have to save a trillion money. I can buy all the buildings I want, but as you can see, I am an amazing, let me whip out this calculator for a second for you guys. Second. I need, let's just call it about 30 million more times what I've got to be able to destroy that wall. And I'm hoping to eventually do enough of these to actually destroy that wall. And that's gonna be awesome. Because when I do, I will have conquered you, wall. I will have conquered. Punches aren't really worth it, but anything helps. So anyway, back to DDR. Now, what makes DDR so appealing is that it has each of its songs as four, maybe even five, okay, depending on the song, difficulty levels. And basically, it straddles everything. Are you an absolute noob who has no coordination skills whatsoever? Well, as long as your feet can get on the panel, my dad has an issue with that. His feet are too big for the panels, but Won't really hit the down arrow very well, but as long as your feet are of a decent size, you can play it. Just click on the beginner levels of the songs and you'll slowly get better. Are you an absolutely hardcore player of these games? Just go to experts. And they also have like certain boss songs, and even those really aren't that hard and really aren't that much harder in the beginning difficulties. It's when you get into like the really high difficulty levels that they actually become difficult. Because the game has evolved a lot. And the game scale is currently rated on a 1 to 20 scale, although I do not think they are ever going to release a 20. They have released only two 19s and about 30 18s. There are just too many to count anywhere else. But the scale used to be from 1 to 10, and enough games were made that if you just go out and randomly find a new one, especially if you have a PlayStation 2, and yes, I know a PlayStation, no one has a PlayStation 2 anymore, but we do, and we love the old thing. Although, really, the only reason we use it anymore is for playing DDR. But if you have one of those, especially, you're probably going to get a 1 to 10 format. And now, that is actually just the 21 to 20 scale compressed. And the reason they switched is because on the 1 to 10 scale, conversions are pretty smooth at first. Well, from 1 to 10 to 1 to 20, but you know things are bad when a 10 on that scale goes all the way from a 15 to a 19 on the scale. On the 1 to 20 scale, and 15 or and 9 15s and 19s are a world apart. Because there are certain step judgments, like timing, and you actually have to be really accurate, like within, I think, half a second to even hit the arrow, a quarter of a second to get a perfect, and an eighth of a second to hit a marvelous. Getting all perfects is known as a perfect full combo. You didn't miss anything and you got everything perfect or marvelous. Even players who can easily get perfect full combos on a 15 often may not even be able to beat a 19. That's how hard these things are. That's how bad the curve gets. And actually, no, I'm not going to buy the Iron Club because I am saving up. I'm saving up for, not coffee, the gun shooter. And now, I think that is just about it. I might talk more later, just like when I'm alone for a while and I feel the need to stay stuff. Well, I am Plantis MC, and I will see you all next time. Goodbye.